what you see behind me is a typical Dutch dike. And these are very tall, they can be meters high, and they can stretch out to everywhere. And you can find them everywhere through the country also. So this is from the side of the houses. But let's go to the other side. Let's go to the other side and see it from the water side. Hello, sheepies. So now we're at the other side of the dike. So you can see that this is the riverside. So the dikes protect the country from this river if it would ever flood. And that's stuff that really can happen because we are very low, below sea level, especially in this area of the Netherlands, in south of Holland. The Netherlands, meaning lowland countries, has struggled with the water of the seas and the rivers for many centuries. Although dikes are not specifically a Dutch invention, other cultures such as Egypt and China used this much longer ago, it is a defining element in the layout of many places in the Netherlands. It is a very usual part of the landscape. The oldest dikes in the Netherlands go as far back as the 11th century. Dikes are built for several reasons concerning water management. It all really started in the year 700 to build up protection from the aggressive North Sea, and later around the year 1000 it also became common practice to protect ourselves from the rivers that could also flood. How low is the Netherlands right now? Well, the lowest point below sea level is in the district called Zuidplas, and is 6.7 meters below sea level. There is a special website that shows you exactly which area is higher than the other. So let's see, based on my zip code, if I would be in trouble. So this is the website, and here I can fill in the zip code, and then as you can see, well, if I translate it, it says yes, it could overflow with 0.5 meters here. About 30% of the total landmass of the Netherlands is located below sea level, but the impacted area when there is a flood is about 55%, much higher. The problem is also that the areas that are the lowest are the most dense populated areas at the same time, with all the large cities being there. Throughout the ages there have been many times that dikes broke with major consequences, so the Dutch realized again and again that this practice of building dikes was crucial to survive. The dikes are built for a particular size of storm. For instance, there are extreme large storms that only happen once in every 100,000 years. Fact is that the dikes won't be able to hold those type of storms, but the chance of this happening is also very small. The costs to prepare the dikes for that would be too high and out of proportion. This is the type of risk assessment that has to be done very precisely here. So the system of protection of dikes and flood barriers does have its limitations. The last big flood that was devastating, especially for the province of Zeeland, was a real wake-up call that also dikes alone were not enough. This well-known national disaster took place in 1953. And in Dutch it's called the Watersnoodramp. The cause was an extreme quickly rising North Sea due to a combination of natural factors. 1836 Dutch people lost their lives because of the flood. The damage for southwest of the Netherlands was enormous. 100,000 persons saw their homes or property destroyed, but also 10,000 of animals lost their life, like all the livestock that was held in the country. Imagine that in one night the sea took back 165,000 hectares of land from the country back. The government already knew that the dikes were weak, but because this were the 50s, the nation already had their hands full with rebuilding the entire country after the Second World War was finished. There was a lot destroyed already and a lot of work to be done everywhere. After this major disaster, the country decided it would need to do more than just build stronger dikes, and so different types of flood barriers were designed and built. Huge constructions that would be able to stop the seas and rivers at critical points. So it wasn't only dikes that were needed, it also required real organizations to take care of all of this work, maintenance and manage all the finances that were required with the dike building business. These type of organizations are called waterschappen, and already exist since 700 years ago. Everyone in the Netherlands, they pay tax to keep these organizations going. Here are some numbers about the dikes. There are 18,000 kilometers of dikes and protection against the water. There are in the Netherlands 225,000 kilometers of water streams. A quarter of the country is below sea level, and more than half of the country is at risk of getting flooded some way or the other. 10 million Dutch citizens live directly behind the protection of either dunes or dikes. The dikes also include 7,500 kilometers of roads on the dikes. For making the dike stronger until 2030, an amount of more than 7 billion euros is reserved. This will take care of 1,100 kilometers of dikes. Also, check out this visualization of the potential number of deaths and costs of the damage that would happen with a giant storm. That's pretty terrifying. See it, and it creates a very nice structure in the environment. You know, you can walk past these dikes, you can walk on top of the dike to have a different view, and it's pretty green always next to the dikes, you know, in the surrounding. It's always a great place to walk around and to sit by the river if you want. So it adds something really nice to an area which is very flat, you know, a country which is very flat. It adds some difference in height, all these dikes that you find in the Netherlands. So it's really something to recommend if you are somewhere in the Netherlands, to walk around and discover these dikes and, you know, just tour on them. It's great also for bicycle riding. So you also find smaller dikes where the houses are very close to it. These are probably older dikes that were built earlier in the past, and later on, you know, other bigger dikes took over in other parts of the country. So that's the way these dikes become a historical part of the country. But you will also see that many streets and road names include the word dike. One last word of advice: when you drive upon a dike with your car, for instance, make sure you don't drive off of it. So that's it for today. Now you know how low the Netherlands are and how the struggle against the water goes on. Make sure to subscribe to the channel and see you in the next video.